Does CRC intake valve and turbo cleaner really work? Today I'm putting it to the test with before and after footage of the intake valves. CRC intake valve cleaner has its work cut out. Now let's get this. I'll start by getting baseline footage of the intake valves on my 2017 Honda Accord, which has a GDI engine. I've used this CRC cleaner previously on the channel, where I tried to answer the question whether carbon from cleaning the intake valves goes on to clog the catalytic converter. However, I only showed before and after shots of the cat and not the intake valves, and so I'm really eager to see how this performs. All spark plugs are out, and I go into cylinder one using the 90 degree camera of my depth step borescope. The intake valve are closed, and to open them I engage the crankshaft bolt through the wheels, and as it opens it becomes clear that CRC intake valve cleaner has its work cut out. There are multiple layers of hard carbon on the valve stem. The back of the valve isn't as bad. There's also carbon deposits on the walls of the intake port. Following the firing order of this engine, I move over to cylinder 3, which has the same hard carbon even though it's not as much as cylinder 1. Next valve to open is cylinder 4, which has a lot of carbon as well, but still less compared to cylinder 1. The final cylinder to fire is cylinder 2, and the valves in this cylinder are the cleanest compared to the rest. Now we have our baseline. I drive the car around in order to get it to operating temperature as recommended by CRC. I'll be using the product through the brake booster line. This brake booster line goes directly to the intake manifold. This air inflator adapter gave me a perfect seal on the booster line while allowing the straw from the CRC intake cleaner to go through. Next, I start up the car and use the case of my torque wrench to set the gas pedal to 2000 RPM, and with this we're good to start spraying. The instructions on the car recommend that you can spray it upright or upside down. I spray in short bursts while allowing the RPM to recover. You don't want to hydrolock your engine by spraying consistently. Not much is happening at the exhaust. There's no smoke at this point. 10 to 15 minutes later, the can is empty, and I rev it 3 times as recommended by CRC. And at this point, you can definitely see that there's smoke coming from the tailpipe, which is essentially part of the product getting burnt off. I allow it to idle for 1 minute as suggested in the instructions and shut it off. After an hour of heat soaking, it's go time for the complimentary spirited drive. I should mention that there was some misfiring initially. If this happens, just drive the car at low RPM till this clears up. Nothing to worry about. It took about 5 minutes for this to clear. The check engine light didn't come on. CRC recommends driving the car for at least 10 minutes at highway speeds. I ended up driving it for about 30 minutes. I come back and this first inspection attempt didn't go down really well. CRC intake valve cleaner is a bit oily and has just left this wet look on the intake valves and in the intake ports, and it's difficult to make a good assessment of what it's been able to clean. This wet look is exactly how my intake valves used to look before I installed an oil catch can, and so I decided to drive the car a bit more over some days to see if the valves will look drier for a better assessment. After 10 days, things look a lot better. For cylinder 1, here's the before and here's the after. You can see that the right side of the valve appears to be a bit cleaner, but the difference is not night and day. In fact, it seems as though the product did most of its cleaning on this part of the wall of the intake port and not on the intake valve itself. In cylinder 2, I don't seem to appreciate any cleaning of the valve itself, but you can see that this side of the wall of the intake port has also been cleaned down to bare metal. It's the same story in cylinder 3. We see a cleaner intake port wall in this area. This part of the valve has also lost some carbon. For cylinder 4, I see no improvement on carbon on the back of the intake valve. In summary, there's some cleaning, but in my opinion, nowhere near the 46% that CRC claims in 1 hour. Let me know what you think in the comments, and I'll catch you on the next one. Peace.